preparing for a more powerful space station, building a more fuel-efficient aircraft, and a way to possibly predict solar flares. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On January 20th, NASA astronaut Nicole Mann and Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Koichi Wakata conducted a spacewalk outside the International Space Station to prepare for future upgrades to the station's power system. The station's existing power channels are being augmented with new rollout solar arrays. On January 18th, we announced a partnership with Boeing to build, test, and fly an experimental full-scale sustainable flight demonstrator aircraft aimed at lowering emissions.
And Boeing's concept is a transonic truss-braced wing single-aisle aircraft.
Learn more about NASA's work in aeronautics research at nasa.gov/flight. Our Solar Dynamics Observatory has identified small-scale flashes in the upper layers of the solar atmosphere, the corona, that could help us predict solar flares, which in turn could help us anticipate the disruptive impacts of space weather storms here on Earth. Teams at our Michoud assembly facility recently completed welding of the Space Launch System, or SLS, core stage liquid oxygen tank dome for Artemis III. The liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen tanks hold the propellant used to launch the SLS and the Orion spacecraft into space. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.